Good morning, fourth graders. Happy Friday. It's Miss DeMonico. I'm just chilling at my house, sipping my coffee as usual. Not much has changed for Miss DeMonico. And getting ready to read the next chapter of Wonder. I am so excited. This book is so good, and we're just in the beginning, fourth graders. Yesterday when we were reading about August's trip home from Christopher's house when he's in the car, and his parents are talking to him about school. And at first, August is super like, I'm not going to school. But at the end of the chapter, when Vio wakes up, he tells Vio, we're talking about my new principal. And that chapter is kind of funny because the principal's name is Mr. Tushman. And in English, fourth graders, one of the ways that tush is another word for saying but, which is why August thinks that Mr. Tushman's name is so funny. So just keep that in mind as we're reading. I'm going to read the next chapter for you because we're going to read about August meeting Mr. Tushman. And it's a really good chapter. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. Paging Mr. Tushman. I would have been more nervous about meeting Mr. Tushman if I'd known I was going to be meeting some kids from the new school. Oh no, so not only is August going to be meeting Mr. Tushman, but he's also going to be meeting students. I would be nervous too. But I didn't know, so if anything, I was kind of giggly. I couldn't stop thinking about all the jokes Daddy had made about Mr. Tushman's name. So when me and Mom arrived at Beecher Prep a few weeks before the start of school, and I saw Mr. Tushman standing there waiting for us at the entrance, I started giggling right away. He didn't look at all like what I pictured, though. I guess I thought he would have had a huge butt, but he didn't. In fact, he was a pretty normal guy. Tall and thin, old but not really old. He seemed nice. He shook my mom's hand first. Hi, Mr. Tushman. It's so nice to see you again, said Mom. This is my son, August. Mr. Tushman looked right at me and smiled and nodded. He put his hand out for me to shake. Hi, August, he said. Totally normal. It's a pleasure to meet you. Hi, I mumbled, dropping my hand into his hand while I looked down at his feet. He was wearing red Adidas. So, he said, kneeling down in front of me so I couldn't look at his sneakers, but I had to look at his face. Your mom and dad have told me a lot about you.
Like, what have they told you?
I asked. Sorry? Honey, you have to speak up, said Mom.
Like what?
I asked, trying not to mumble. I admit, I have a habit of mumbling. Well, that you like to read, said Mr. Tushman, and that you're a great artist. He had blue eyes with white eyelashes.
And you're into science, right?
Uh-huh, I said, nodding. We have a couple of great science electives at Beecher, he said. Maybe you'll take one of them. Uh-huh, I said, though I had no idea what an elective was.
So, are you ready to take a tour?
You mean we're doing that now? I said.
Did you think we were going to the movies? He answered,
smiling as he stood up. You didn't tell me we were taking a tour, I said to Mom in my accusing voice. Augie, she started to say. It'll be fine, August, said Mr. Tushman, holding his hand out to me. I promise. I think he wanted me to take his hand, but I took Mom's instead. He smiled and started walking toward the entrance. Mommy gave my hand a little squeeze, though I don't know if it was an I love you squeeze or an I'm sorry squeeze, but probably a little of both. The only school I'd ever been inside before was Via's. When I went with Mom and Dad to watch Via sing in spring concerts and stuff like that, this school was very different. It was smaller, and it smelled like a hospital. All right, fourth graders, that's the next chapter. I have a couple of things I want to point out to you. First of all, in the beginning, August says that he's going to meet some kids, which we didn't know, and they haven't been introduced yet. So I'm really looking forward to seeing what happens with that. But there are two things that Augie does, fourth graders, that I noticed that Mr. Garcia and I teach you guys not to do, and there's a better way of handling it. And I want to see if you can catch what they are. The first one is the handshake. I'm going to reread this part to you. So, Mr. Tushman says, it's a pleasure to meet you, and he puts his hand out in front of him for Augie to shake. Listen to what Augie does.
Hi,
I mumbled, dropping my hand into his hand while I looked down at his feet. He was wearing red Adidas.
After you finish this video, fourth graders, I want you to reply in the comments, what should Augie have done when shaking Mr. Tushman's hand? Because it's not that. The second thing I noticed, fourth graders, was Mr. Tushman asks August a couple of questions. And listen to how August responds. And you're into science, right? Uh-huh, I said, nodding. Maybe you'll take one of the science electives. Uh-huh, I said, though I had no idea what an elective was. Those uh-huhs aren't very respectful, are they, fourth graders? In the comments, I want you to write down how should August have responded to Mr. Tushman when he was speaking to them based on what Mr. Garcia and I have been teaching you all year long. All right, fourth graders, I hope you have a great Friday. I hope you enjoy the chapter, and I will see you on Monday. Bye.